ITV. Come on in.
These men are here to learn how to kill.
Why do you look so scared, Joe?
That's got to come out, hasn't it?
Many are still teenagers and have never lived away from home.
Day one, this is when they start. As soon as they come off the train, as soon as their name's been ticked off on that sheet, they're ours, they're with us, yeah, we've got them.
Stop mincing, Joe! Get sprinting!
They're about to begin the Parachute Regiment's elite 28-week recruitment course. It's the most brutal test of body and mind in the British Army.
Get moving! Now!
Attack it!
The men that trained them have been to war. They know what it takes to become a para.
All right, come on. Stay with it, Joe, you're right. Don't patrol down nice, straight pavements, okay? It's always on this shit.
I'm pissed off myself that I'm not getting it through here. It's like it's going in there and coming out there.
Boys will need to become soldiers, capable of taking a life.
Our bread and butter is soldiering in the field, closing with the enemy and killing him.
To finally earn the regiment's maroon beret will be a test of character and courage. Only a handful will succeed.
I've got here 20.
20, yeah.
Right, Joe, grab all your kit, make sure you don't leave anything behind. Follow on behind me. Yeah, we're gonna get on the coach and get ourselves to Catterick.
The moment I'm given that rifle and on that plane jumping out into a war-torn country, I'm not going to be able to, you know, call my mum and ask her to give me a hug. You know, it's about just, you know, growing a pair and getting the job done.
Hey, Joel, yeah, I appreciate now you don't know how to march, OK? So everyone now turn and face that way. OK, all you're going to do, you're just going to walk, swing your arms across your body.
The first day in training is like a massive shock of capture. You have no idea what's going on. They'll probably instantly regret their decision. But I suppose that's almost how we want them to be. We don't want them to be knowing exactly what they're going into and being calm and collected on the day. We need them to feel that stress.
Imagine us now as a big family. Everyone left and right here, behind you, are your brothers. You look after them like they're your own family. Your section commanders, yeah, they're your uncles that you look up to, and they will steer you in the right directions. Me, I'm your dad, yeah. If you've got any problems, yeah, you come and see me. At the same time, discipline issues, yeah, I'm your dad, I'm gonna punish you. Does everyone understand that?
Yes, Sergeant.
We are a family, we work together, we get results. You've got there the best corporals in the Parachute Regiment. Feel privileged and feel a bit of pride that they're getting to teach you. Everything they teach you, take it on board. The only people that will fail you now is yourselves. Everything you do now, you put maximum effort into it. Another thing which I haven't mentioned yet, you are now Joes. It doesn't matter what background you've come from, whether you've been the lowest of the low or you've been well educated, it does not matter. You are all equal as men, right? Haircuts. Some of you are looking like One Direction at the moment, yeah? Every man here will have a haircut tonight. We're all brothers, we're all part of the same thing. You're gonna lose that hair, you're all gonna be in one boat.
Shaving my head, being called Joe, having that fresh new start and building yourself into becoming this new person that is way better than what you was in Civvy Street. Because I could tell you now, you know, if I was to pass out, I'll be a complete different person. You know, I'll just look at my old self and say, yeah, I'm done with you. You know, you could go back in the closet and then I could be showing off this new person I am.
everyone happy?
Yes, Sergeant.
Right, what I want you to do is get out in the corridor. Let's go. Hurry up.
The name Joe stands for Joined on Enlistment. The 40 will all be called Joe for as long as they remain on the course. The recruits are being stripped of their civilian identity.
Who is Joe? Joe is me. I am Joe.
We're all Joe. That's me. That's all I'm ever going to be for the next 7 months. Joe, that's us. Nothing more, nothing less.
It is definitely a little bit weird getting your identity stripped away from you. I'm known as Chad, I am Chad. And then you come here and then you're like, I'm not Chad.
My parents always told me that I should find my groove in life. I should never follow anybody. I was a very nervous, very worried child, so I'd worry about what I wanted to be. And I wanted to be a paleontologist, game ranger. And then my father gave me the idea of the army. And I thought, army. Well, I like fitness. I like discipline. I love being a gentleman. And if I could hold a gun and shoot a gun, that would be pretty cool.
You look like a fucking man now, don't you, Joe?
Yes, Corporal.
One of them fucking curly locks. You just see civilians, to be fair. They don't have a clue. They really don't have a clue. They turn up, they're trying to be pally-pally. Yeah, you're all right, mate, and all that. And you're just like, you haven't got a clue. But you can't drop the hammer on them straight away at the train station. For me, it's good to see they've turned up to try and give it a go, you know? When they first turn up, yeah, they're just a shell. I mean, they're not what you want. They're not reacting to how you react. But you can't expect that on day one, you know? You've got plenty of time to turn them into what you want to turn them into.
After 10 days, the platoon leaves the barracks for the first time to begin the very basics of being a paratrooper.
We may not have the best soldier. However, we think we do. You ask a para to climb up a mountain and he may not have done it before, but he'll believe that he can do it. And it is that pure confidence in ourselves that means we do well in everything we do.
Right, Joe, OK? Welcome to Intro X1, OK? This is your first exercise or first lesson that's been taught out in the field. What we're going to move on today is methods of movement. So that's you moving across a battle space at the best speed possible. Everyone understand that?
Yes, Corporal.
OK, so as Corporal Murray shows you now, you need to do this with purpose, Joe. You need to move as fast as you fucking can. OK, so once he gets down, gonna get nice and low. See how low he gets and how he moves with purpose. Think about it, creeping up on the enemy, knowing they've been shooting at you and your friends, and you're gonna post a grenade straight into him. That grenade is gonna blow up, it blow him to pieces, and then you're gonna come over the top and start shooting him. Best feeling in the world, Joe. That is where we're going. That is what you should want to be doing. That is the end product, Joe. Do you understand?
Yes, go, bro!
Good. Get out the front, let's go. Get fucking moving, good work.
I wasn't brought up the normal way most children were. My father and my mother brought me up with an iron fist. I had corporal punishment. They always told me, manners maketh a man.
You want to win, Joe, you want to be first. Paratroopers are always first, Joe.
My father gave me three options that were I was able to do without any problems, which was, of course, South African Army, French Foreign Legion, or the British Army.
Get with your section commander! Get out the front! Let's go! Get fucking moving! Good work!
This is my second time of joining the military. The first time I joined when I was 17. I left a few years after that.
I miss the military life and the job itself. And at my age now, I want to go all out. I mean, it's the last hurrah for me at my age now. This is my last chance to be something.
This is my first time away from home. I've lived a sheltered life. I've had mum do my laundry, dad give me money. It's a transition from, you know, being a kid, now turning into a man.
the environments that we work in, Joe, OK? We don't patrol down nice, straight pavements, OK? It's always on this shit, undulating terrain. That means bumpy ground, etc., OK? Look at me when I'm fucking speaking. Stop looking at the ground. Some of you are just mincing. You're here to take the money and fuck off. That is it. Get some aggression about you, Joe. You're not in the fucking civilian world. You're in the fucking army now. That is it.
The platoon of 40 recruits is attempting to join the paras. Seen as the elite of the British Army, only a handful will succeed.
So this is our office, this is where we do business. You get them out here and it's time to go to work. So this is where you earn your money. So you come out here and this is where you train to be a soldier. You don't train in camp to be a soldier, you train out here to be a soldier.
Right, Joe, at no point the other day did I say it was a fucking picnic, did I? Okay, it is no good having rations everywhere, because if the worst happens and you get contacted by the enemy and we need to get the fuck out of here or we need to fight, your kit needs to be almost good to go. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Right, come on, start sparking.
They are sort of like your parents, because you do something wrong, they'll teach you a lesson. You do something right, they'll reward you. They give you all the knowledge that you need, and they're there every step of the way, even if it seems like fucking arseholes.
Pick the fucking weapon up then. Where's your sling?
I haven't got one, Corporal.
Of course you haven't.
Get that shit away, hurry up.
Just little things that you don't think you're gonna get told off for, like leaving your weapon there. You thought it was boy, yeah, but they want your claws on your lap. It's just a ball, like when you're trying to cook and you got a weapon on your lap. Yeah.
How are you two getting on? Have you stuck your thumb to me, Avery?
Yes, Corporal.
We're not fucking getting it, are we?
We cannot be their best friend through training. We almost encourage this mentality of us and them between Joe and the training team, because it binds them together as a group, and then they have this sort of enemy, if you like, in inverted commas, that they can work against. Clearly that's, you know, not the case, but in some respects, we sort of encourage that.
Do you think we're friends, Avery?
Pardon,
do you think we're friends?
No, Corporal.
What is that doing out? You don't need any shit out. Fucking throw it away.
The recruits are on their first night exercise and need to avoid being captured by the corporals.
Little mice, you can hear them just scurrying around.
We need a lot of basic soldiering skills, staying unseen, cover ground tactically. Only then, when we have those basics done well, can we start to look at things like attacking. It would be akin to building a house. You need to lay the foundations first, and then you start to build up.
Back up to the top. And you, bell end.
Just had a joke, yeah, crawl through a ditch that is up to his eyeballs. I showed some commitment. I'm not willing to go in there at this stage. I would have boxed around this and I'll catch him on the other side.
Fucking hell! Who's that there, Joe? Latham, I've just gone up to my fucking tits in water to catch you.
Let's go, bro.
Fucking hell. Who's that?
Sorry, Corporal. I didn't know you were there, Corporal.
Oh, you didn't know anything, did you? Yeah? If you'd stay perfectly still, I want to come over, OK? Because I can't see you in a bush. I can just hear you.
Yes, Corporal.
Right, off you go back to the beginning.
The platoon have taken turns to be on lookout throughout the night. The temperature has plummeted to minus 10.
I'm not used to this temperature at all. Never was.
Took me a long time to get used to it, but I survived the night.
You get so cold, you almost go warm. So, because you're shivering so much, you just go warm, but then it's your face, man. Like the wind just blows in and cuts through your face.
I want to be a paratrooper. If I need to go through this, I will go through it.
Some of yous now will be thinking, although you won't admit it to me, but in your head, some of yous will be thinking, I don't think this is for me. I don't like exercise. It's too cold, okay? In your head now, think of a goal. It's only going to get easier, yeah? Because the weather is going to be the main thing that makes you suffer on exercise, right? Don't let it affect you when it is getting cold, because that's when you start getting bollockings and things like that for section commanders.
So yeah.
Yeah, the fucking forearm cramped.
Justin's out there, Joe.
That's not a nice thing at all.
What then, Joe? Platoon sergeant, we normally do the fucking platoon sergeant's inspection. He will call out some items. We will then come round and check you. Everyone happy? So the first thing we want to see then is gas parts, Joe.
Stop fucking shaking, Cole, Joe. Get a grip of your body. Go to your fucking happy place. Where's your happy place, Cole, Joe?
Jumping out.
What was you about to say? Jumping out of planes? Have you ever jumped out of a plane? So where's your fucking happy place?
I don't know, Cole.
They look at you. They're trying to figure out, who is this Joe? What's about him? Why is he here? You know, is he worth my time?
Fucking get the weapon to wipe down, all right? Because it's been snowing and shit. All these metal parts are just going to get rusty as fuck, like the trigger.
You know, the training team, they're amazing, because the fact that they're invested into trying to make you become one of them, it says a lot.
Why is that not full?
They told me it was full.
Weapon above your head. Get your weapon above your head. What do you mean they told me it was full? It's your fucking water bottle. Get your weapon above your head. Don't fucking mince. Get there.
Stop fucking mincing, Joe. Get sprinting.
I want to be the grey man. And the grey man basically means going under the radar, not being known to the corporals or sergeants. So other people always get called.
Get moving, you! Get fucking moving! All the way in, go on!
They don't know me as someone they'd call. So I'll still go to, like, Corporal Duncan, and he'll still be like, who are you? Like, he doesn't actually know my name, but obviously the other corporals do, but there's only so much of a grey man you can be in training.
Right, put your fucking body armour the right way round. That is inside out. I don't know how you've managed to do that. Go on, get a grip of yourself.
I'm so, you know, it's just sometimes I'm not there. It's like I'm in the clouds. It's just I'm thinking ahead of myself, because the only thing I'm thinking about is that maroon beret, you know, that going on my head and me jumping out of a plane.
You'll learn the hard way, Joe.
It hasn't been a good start. I've been picked up, I've been noticed. And that's all for bad reasons. It's left a mark on me.
Raymer, in you come.
Right, Bremer, look at me, OK? Do you know why I might have possibly called you in here?
It's because of my progress, sir.
And what about your progress?
It's not been good, sir.
OK, so it's not been up to the standard required of you at this stage. What's going on?
It's my mindset, sir.
What about your mindset?
I still have not clicked on. I still have not told myself that I'm in a military establishment where I need to be fully focused. That's the problem, sir.
So what are you focused on other than the stuff you're meant to be doing?
It's worry, sir.
Worry? About?
About my progress, sir.
OK. Now, there's no need to worry about it, because all that happens, OK, is that that problem will snowball. OK? So what you've done is, you are looking back at the problems that you're facing and the things that you've done wrong, okay? Not forward to the next thing. Now, what I need to see from you is stop trying to second guess what's coming and just do as you're told, and that will get you a long way. I don't want to see you back in this office, okay, again.
Yes, sir.
Right, out you go. Prop the door up. Door, Bramer.
15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. To be honest with you, I'm pissed off with myself that I'm not getting it through here. It's like it's going in there and coming out there, which is, you know, pissing me off because, you know, if this was the battlefield and I was given an order and it goes out here, my friends die, and who's to blame? Me.
Think about the end of the 28 weeks. Think about wearing that maroon beret.
Over the next 3 weeks, the corporals push the platoon harder. Any recruits not fully dedicated will fail the course.
I suppose for outsiders looking in, some of the things we do and ask Joe to do could seem draconian, could seem a bit insane, but we have a purpose for everything.
Joe, I do not understand why you're walking with a casualty. He's fucking bleeding out. Get shifted.
It's absolutely my responsibility and the responsibility of the training team to produce good paratroopers.
Where I'm stood now, this is called the firing point. Okay, behind you is the troop shelter. That's where you'll be if you're not on the firing point.
You do not want to be known at your battalion as the person that passed out Joes that weren't good enough. That will come back to me and the training team. And that is not something I want.
Tuck it! Spread!
If their skills aren't good enough, if they're not physically robust enough, they may not come back from operations. That is the potential to either live or die. It's not acceptable to send people to a battalion where I have friends that they will have to work for and they aren't making the cut.
One more time, so I jump off, each foot, and then boom.
Just like that, right? Like fucking Superman. I take it you've seen fucking Superman in movies and shit. Come on,
right, get to the end there.
Get it, come on! Get moving! Get moving!
Better, get down, go away.
Good, keep going. Arms out! Attack it! Stand up! Stand up! Get back to the beginning!
It's week 5 of the 28-week training course. To become a paratrooper, the recruits have to learn what it takes to survive in the harshest of conditions.
I haven't seen weather like this in 12 years. It's because I moved to South Africa 12 years ago. Born South African, came here for 6 years, then moved back to South Africa. And I think I saw snow only once or twice.
Last time it snowed all this was when I was like 10, and it wasn't as bad as this.
On the good side, my milk will always stay cold. Nice cold weather.
Keep the milk cold.
Milk!
Not milk, milk.
From the right. I realise you've had a long night and morale might be a bit low. Okay, what we've got in the platoon is a rising star. Yeah, X Factor South Africa finalist. Yeah, in Private Avery. So what Private Avery's gonna do, he has got quite good vocal cords. He's gonna sing to you like they used to do in the trenches in the World Wars. Things like that, they used to sing to raise morale. Yeah. Avery, come out. Okay, let's give it a little spiel. Let's bring the morale of the troops up.
Well, you only need the lights when it's burning low. Only miss the sun when it starts to snow. Only know you love her when you let her go.
My morale's lifting.
And you let her go.
So laughing, Joe.
He's putting the effort in to sing to you.
Only the lights when it's burning low. I only miss the sun when it starts to snow. Woo. Only know you love her when you let her go.
Start humming, Joe, with his chorus.
Oh, go on. Staring at the ceiling in the dark. Same old empty feeling in your heart. As love comes slow and they go so fast.
A slight click as well, Joe. Mm.
Will you let her go?
Right, well done, Avery. Dress back in.
What the
right,
hell?
Everyone stand at ease. Right, get away, go.
By the fifth week, the recruits should be competent in handling their weapon, able to dismantle and reassemble it in less than 5 minutes.
Right, come in, take control of your weapons. Right, Joe, you're gonna strip your weapon, okay? Just think about your drills, what you do before you strip your weapon.
17-year-old Private Kojo Bramer is doing well with the physical aspect of the course, although he's finding maintaining his kit more of a problem. But assault rifles are nothing new to 31-year-old Private Parry. He previously spent 4 years in the army after leaving school.
I want to prove something to myself. Like, since I've left the army, it's been a struggle. I've had no direction, no path. I've had so many jobs that I couldn't keep count of. It's been ridiculous, you know? Not only that, my little girl, she's my motivation. She's the one, primarily, what I'm doing it for. I don't want her growing up knowing that Daddy was a soldier. I want her growing up knowing that Daddy is a soldier.
Back in. Right, slow down and think about what you're doing. Whoa, whoa, wait, Bramer, slow down. Think about what you're doing. Right, Bramer, I can't take any more. I accept you're nervous, but it shouldn't take you about 45 attempts to put the bolt in, should it? Right, you've been shown enough times. I'm gonna give you less than 30 seconds, and that needs to be in there. Right, stop there, Bramer. Right, we're just gonna have to go over this again, aren't we? Okay, right, go on.
I just can't believe how I messed that up. I got so nervous, I was in the moment, I just can't believe I fucked that up. A simple bit of, like, wow. It's just, I just don't want to fail, because if I fail, I have nothing to go to. That's me done, finished.
If Private Kojo Bramer fails in his boyhood dream of becoming a paratrooper, he won't be the first to go. Two recruits have quit already.
I will keep going. Failure is not an option. Even if my muscles tear and my bones break, I will try and get up. I'll keep crawling. That's the motto that we go through. It's what these paratroopers do. They just go.
Last one, let's go. Get the arms, legs going, move.
Drive to the blade, back round, go.
30 seconds.
Tough as shit.
The platoon is on an 8-mile tab, or tactical advance to battle. The paras are expected to be first in and must be able to travel long distances at speed, carrying over 50 kilos of kit.
Let's ask you a question. What are we doing back here? Get the fuck up there now. Do you understand me? Put the fucking effort in there. Let's go. Stand by.
Yeah.
Go. Let's go. Stay with me. Come on.
Get fucking moving!
Now! Talking to my fucking self!
Suck it up!
Why is tabbing so important? It's that bread and butter. Pirate's bread and butter. Instilled into you from day one. What we do best. Essentially dropped in behind enemy lines. Tab to her, and that'll be. And then we'll smash the enemy.
Coursing the Falklands, race to get to Stanley between us and the Royal Marines. The fitness with the Parachute Regiment born. We were first in. We'll still have to win the battles.
Being trained to keep going under any circumstance can be the difference between life and death.
It's not a normal feat to see one of your friends dead or people missing limbs.
Shake your head.
Okay, sit down. Take your burden off. Sit down. Stop fucking flapping. Take your burden off.
I got injured in a roadside bomb that killed one of my friends and the officer that was in the front of the vehicle. I was injured in it. And at that point, although at the time I didn't think it, it was where the training kicks in, like the determination and things like that.
Relax. In through your nose. Look at me. In through your nose. Look at me. I'm through your mouth. Saying, relax. You're having a panic attack, Joe. You're fine. Yeah, your lungs will feel heavy.
I went round to check one of the lad's pulses. He was obviously dead at the time, so I seen that. And I think it's just that, you know, that training from the off of being ready, like, for any situation. So I just grabbed my weapon and carried on.
What are you crying for?
Is
this from falling over?
No.
Fucking just tell us. Stop trying to be a man and let us know what's going on.
I'm gapping my fucking head. I can't feel my head. But
right, get your smock on. That's all you got to fucking say, innit? In fact, I'll tell you what to do.
It's all you work hard on that.
Put your smock on. Put your smock on. Put your hands inside your pockets and stand there. Right, because your hands will get warm off your fucking... Happy?
If you've fucking got an issue, we need to know.
Come down the hill!
Wait, what was going on? I took a hard fall on the when Tisby came down from the tap. I didn't want to let them know, so I just carried on.
Yeah, how tough is it to put your hand up and say I can't do it?
It's scary. You don't know what they're thinking when you put your hand up. Oh, they look at this guy, he's weak. Why is he putting his hand up? What sufficient reason does he have? I just have a sore knee. I can't feel my left hand. That's nothing. It's crap.
My father was in the army, and he told me, listen, York, I want you to think of this. Think in your mind whenever they're making you do push-ups, whenever they make you run, and whenever you feel tired and sore and you want to give up. You must learn to understand that they're just breaking your body. They're giving you a mentality so that you can act in the way that they want you to act. You can break my body, but you can never break my spirit and my mind.
I made more friends in here than I did in my entire school career. I did 12 years of schooling. I made only 4 to 5 friends, two of which are my closest. Here, I've got a whole section as my friend. I don't really want to disappoint them.
We are the tip of the army spear. We are built to close with and destroy the enemy. yes, we can do drill. Yes, we can do peacetime operations, and we're very good at those. However, our bread and butter is soldiering in the field, closing with the enemy and killing him.
Don't fucking get there then! Stop fucking mincing!
The platoon has completed a third of the course. Five recruits have already left. The remaining 35 must now learn how to kill the enemy.
Your orders are to patrol along the stream bed. If you encounter any enemy, you have to destroy the enemy, understand?
Moving!
Having a child, it has changed my temperament. I mean, you do get defensive, your back does get up. Being in the military, I'm defending her. And I will attack and I will defend. So I'll come to you, simple as. And the powers are the first ones in. Look forward to seeing you.
With my dad being in the army, I naturally asked him, did you take the life of another? Did you kill another man? And my father looked at me and was very silent. And he looked away and then he looked back at me and he said, York, I'm not going to tell you that. If I had to guess, he definitely took a life, multiple lives even. I feel the stuff he did there, he will regret.
Enemy clear!
Like, I guarantee that if it was like a few years back and we're still going to Afghan, some people won't be here now, knowing that if they pass out, they'd go straight to Afghan. I think some people would have left. The actual realism of actually hitting something and actually doing something and knowing that people are shooting back at you as well and they can actually hurt or kill you. It's a weird concept, but it's really weird. You just want to do that even though you know you could get hurt, but you still want to do it.
The recruits have been on exercise for 3 nights. It's been -5 degrees, and they've barely slept. They're preparing for a critical kit inspection. Failing this means they'll be ordered off the course.
Why have you got it all in there? How much have you got in there? Do you need all that in your day sack? Do you think that's fighting order? Joe, it goes in your bargain. Some of you are loading yourselves down too heavy with all this kit. Makes you ineffective on the fucking battle space. You just can't cut about and do your fucking job. You've done better on the last exercise. You're doing worse on this one. What's happened? Someone fucking talk then. Have a bit of balls about you.
Complacency.
Complacency. There you go. And what happens when we get complacent, Leigh?
Fuck up.
We fuck up. What happens when we fuck up on operations?
Got killed a couple.
People get fucking shot and people get killed. The day you get complacent, Joe, the day one of you will take a fucking round.
My dad's always said from day one, why would you want to go away to a country and get shot at? He works in an office doing all like loans and working with money, so it's two completely different jobs. So he's kind of looked at me like, you're crazy, and he'll read the training plan and he'll be like, some of the things you do are just out this world. He thinks I'm insane for wanting to do it.
I went in here and I had the mindscape, I'll do this. I'll prove to my dad, I'm just like him. Better, stronger, independent, robust. Only now I realize I'm not.
Come on, Joe, you up, get the fucking helmet.
I want to quit. I want to go home, home to Africa, where it's warm, it's cozy, it's nice.
Stop chatting shit and just get on with it.
Shut your fucking mouth before I kick your fucking ass. Come on, fucking boots.
Be honest, KJ, have you cleaned this?
I have. Cool.
This is my one-way ticket of, you know, actually becoming someone. And that Maroon Beret and officially becoming paratrooper.
Rust and carbon all over the weapon.
I was always trying to find myself, and coming here, you know, I've truly found the person I am. If I succeed, well, you know, it's a big win because I can forge that new identity I've been looking for. The way I see it is more like do or die. If I don't do it, well, I'm back to where I was, back in Surrey Street, just, you know, wandering about aimlessly.
I called you
on
for breakfast this morning.
For breakfast this morning.
Take your ear defence out.
I was unable to have breakfast.
You was what?
Unable to have breakfast.
You was unable to have breakfast? Why?
So I was doing the weapon first.
You're doing the weapon first, yeah, that's what we always do. You combat effective, you're not have breakfast.
I'm not effective.
You're not effective at all. How long are you going to last for without eating anything?
I won't be able to last.
So, what does that say to me?
KJ failed that one. It's not a one-off. This is a pattern of behaviour, and it's been like this way since week one. So it's not like he's had a shocker today, or he had a shocker yesterday. It's been every inspection since he arrived. Not eating breakfast is just, like, criminal.
Where's your pocket undone? Sorry?
That's my map.
I know it's your fucking map pocket. Why is it all undone?
Couldn't fit
it in properly. Did I show you how to fold a map correctly? Do you think you folded it correctly? You haven't folded it correctly. Because you're a fucking dick. You're gonna go anyway. You're fucking gone. You're done. Don't even care.
Right, Kojo, in you come.
Oh, shit. One, two, three.
Kojo, why do you think you might be stood in front of me?
I failed, sir.
Sorry?
I failed, sir.
Failed what?
The exercise, sir.
Paratroopers don't fail, okay? We learn. And there is a real difference in mindset there, okay? It's easy. Easy route is to say, oh, I failed, move on. Learning from mistakes is better. Right, Kojo, you are going to be back squadded.
Yes, sir.
There's two things you can do now. You can do the old Kojo thing, right, of flapping under pressure, or there's going to be Kojo Mark II. He's going to have a growth mindset. He's going to see this as an opportunity to learn and an opportunity to do really well and be set up for success. Learning from mistakes, getting up when you're knocked down, that's a person I can take to war. Understand?
Yes, sir.
Oh, off you go.
One, two, three. Yes.
Private Kojo Bramer has been back squadded. This means he'll get a second chance of becoming a para by retraining in 2 months' time with the next platoon of new recruits.
It is disheartening, but at the same time, like everyone said, you know, I'm just 17. I can use this to my advantage. I have more time to prepare. So.
Try your best. Focus on what needs to be focused on. Not necessarily your boots, being a soldier.
Okay.
Yeah. I fucking hope this will make you a better soldier, if that makes
sense. Yeah, I understand where you're coming from. You know, I appreciate the help you've given me, but, you know, I'm just going to take everything you told me, apply it to the next training platoon, and then hopefully I'll pass out. But, you know, thank you very much, bud. I will.
Right.
Cheers, man.
See you in the regiment.
See you in the regiment.
That's him.
Hold, check, 1, 2. So I'm 3029101 for Private Avery, sir.
Thank you very much, Avery. Stand at ease. Relax.
Okay. What I want you to do now, we're just going to have a quick chat for the next 10 minutes or so, all right? And just talk to me like you would one of your mates. I want to know the real reasons why you want to leave. And most importantly, I want you to be able to look me square in the eye and say, 100%, I want to go. That's where we want to be by the end of this interview. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay, in your own words then, just why are you thinking why you want to leave?
I've gotten to a point where I'm just at a constant battle. It's on one side, it tells me, you know, just go. You're not happy. And the other side says, stay because you're going to regret it. Your family will be disappointed in you. And I've just gone to the point where I'm tired of saying, yes and then no, and no then yes, and then yes and then no. I want to make a firm decision. Another reason to be is because although this was my dream, I've always had a backup plan, and one is actually singing, which I love very much.
You can sing?
Yes, sir.
Are you any good?
I think so, sir.
Crack on.
Bill is leaving today. Don't know where he's going. Holds his head in disgrace. He can't escape the truth. He knows the price that he's paid. He admits that it's too late to admit that he's afraid. Tomorrow comes, sorrow becomes a soulmate.
Okay, I'm not Simon Cowell, but okay, you can sing. Fantastic. But it's the fact you've had a backup plan.
Why did you even bother coming straight here?
Because at first, I always stick to my first base plan. And my first base plan was the army.
I can see your mind is made up anyway. So I need to draw this interview to a close, okay?
Thank you, sir.
Okay, no dramas.
2-3 up, 2-3 down.
Thank you, Avery, we're done.
At first, I was very happy being here. But slowly, my happiness just started slipping away. I had to rely more on others to help me. And my inability to really lean on people came in and I cracked. I underestimated the meaning of being a Joe. It was tough. So this selection has definitely changed who I am. I'm physically and mentally stronger. And I actually thought I wouldn't change at all.
York Avery is now living back in South Africa with his family. He still hopes to become a singer. Private Kojo Bramer hasn't given up on becoming a para. We follow as he retrains with the next platoon of Joes.
Right, Joe, you're about to take part in one of the most aggressive parts of training.
Next time, with 9 recruits gone, the remaining 31 face the toughest part of the course.
Right, Joe, rest your hand on your head.
But only a handful will succeed in becoming a para.
What are you doing, Joe? Just been killed, haven't you? All good to you now if you're fucking dead.